right, welcome to this.
I've been calling it Zell campaign.
Sure.
I like this.
Zell's in Space Volume 1.
This is this.
This is this Volume 1.
This is this Volume 1. You start off on...
Wait, this is this can
chapter
be...
Chapter 1.
Can be abbreviated to TIT.
Yeah, welcome to TIT.
Okay, we gotta move on from this now.
Moving on. You start off on the serene planet of Galinus. Most of you have grown up here all your life. The looks of it. Some of you, in particular, Mr. Billy Starfield, we're not really sure what his deal is, but
I've been around in space.
Regardless, you've all got dreams. Somewhere you want to be, something you want to do. But the first step for that is getting a ship. As you can see, you've been saving up for quite a while. You nearly got enough. There's one last job given to you by Mr. Glenn Hoffman, your local shopkeep. After he happened upon some land for a cheap price. And in his words, it's changed hands so many times in the past few years, you'd think it was haunted or something. And no offense, but the types ready to hop on their fancy cruiser ships, buy a bunch of land, and attempt to start a farm as if it's another factory they can run to the ground. Probably don't know much about pest control. Bet they were in over their head when their crops for the season all vanished. And so he sent... he's sending you out to take care of the situation. He's left some poisoned bait that hopefully should be gone by the time you get there to hopefully set you on a trail to find its nest. That's where we begin. In the empty field where the bait was laid just hours ago.
Don't worry, guys. I've dealt with this 1,000 times. I know exactly what we're dealing with here.
Jesus.
I haven't heard
that one before.
They're man-eating space rabbits. I'm almost 100% sure of it.
Is that a thing? Do you guys know if that's a thing?
It's a thing. Listen, I think I know what I'm talking about. I've been in space.
I'll let you roll space-wise if you want to see if it's a thing.
I'll roll.
I'm going to do that.
If it's a thing, I'll cut them down in a second.
Straight space-wise?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, straight space-wise. I'll just use, how many cards did you do?
What the hell?
Oh.
Why is it?
They are.
Oh, it's tied to our decks. Holy shit.
Yeah, hopefully it'll help alleviate some wrongful placement. It probably won't matter. I can just open the discard up one for everyone, I think.
Oh yeah, and I'm gonna use 4 drive just because.
Yeah, but I've got no clue.
Shit. Yeah, I think I know a little bit more about space rabbits than you both.
You definitely think they're a thing.
Hell yeah, dude. Listen, I know what I'm talking about, okay? Yeah.
You see this definitely badge? Think they're a thing, and nobody else really knows enough to dispute you on that.
The president gave me this badge for finding space rabbits, hunting them down.
Yeah. Can I examine that badge and see if it's actually has anything to do with space rabbits?
It definitely has a rabbit on it.
Sure, I'm not sure what that would be. Maybe
rabbits are cute.
It might
though.
Also be.
It's doesn't sound very heroic to cut down rabbits.
They're man eating. Don't worry.
Oh,
they eat people like us. So you know, it's one of those kind of situations. Yep.
If they actually eat people, you probably shouldn't worry about what they are.
Exactly. Well, they are rabbits, though. I'm pretty sure.
Okay, great. Pretty sure. Wow.
Well, I've dealt with, you know, I've dealt with a lot of stuff like this. You know, these are telltale signs of man-eating space rabbits. That's what I'm trying to say. In my professional opinion, I think I know a little bit more than you do, considering I was hired by the president.
So you keep saying that, but you won't tell us what president.
The president of space.
Okay, I'm not doing this again. Where are the fucking rabbits?
Well, you could.
I would look around for rabbit tracks.
I'd say that's gonna be, well, let's say wit and survival.
Ooh, I have two survival.
The survival. The unfortunately rare survival.
One success.
I'll just use, like, I don't know, like a couple drive. Yeah, there you go.
Oh, you definitely see some tracks in the ground. There is a faint smell of the putrid meat that was left in the open sun.
Yep. I see some tracks over here, boys. You know, there's a. Yep.
Did looks I do like, anything with my one success? I mean, we tracked rabbits. Them, but.
I'll say it's more of a collaborative effort.
Yeah.
Rather than like straight up, but yeah.
Me and
two success, one or two, you'd probably smell it, but you know the tracks are a bit more defining.
Are they rabbit shaped at all?
I was gonna ask the same question.
Do we have enough successes to determine that?
I will say it's not shaped like any rabbit you've seen.
Yeah, these they're not typical rabbits. You know, they're man-eating space rabbits, okay? So that's kind of why they've got these talons and whatnot.
I don't even know what regular rabbits look like. I can't remember. But,
they have fur and they jump. They're like frogs.
I don't know what a frog looks like.
With bigger ears. Oh. So they look like rabbits without the fur and the ears. I'm gonna follow the tracks.
Yeah, I'm also going to.
Fair enough. On following the tracks,
we all follow.
Yeah, assuming none of you have any other plans, following the tracks will lead you to what appears to be a small cave entrance. And at this point, once the dirt and grass kind of transitions into rock, it's a bit harder to see exactly where they went, but definitely somewhere in there. And Glenn wants you to get rid of the source. He certainly doesn't want them coming back anytime soon. So.
You guys got any dynamite? Who brought the dynamite? Damn it. Okay, well, I guess we got to go in. You guys lead on.
I'll go first.
Because of my stature.
The dark and kind of stale-smelling cave.
And can we see in here? Is it like a deep cave?
I have my hard light weapon out. Does those illuminate at least a little bit around?
I'll say your hard light, as well as your roadie, could probably light up to some as well.
I was gonna ask if I had a flashlight on my space helmet.
I'm gonna have Rhodey create like an extra bright little like harmonica with one of those things you put use to hold it on your face. I'm gonna hold it on my head like a fucking like a miner's lamp.
Hell yeah!
I'm just holding a little torch.
Yeah, I was thinking more like a big flashlight, just like duct taped to it.
Fair enough. I feel like you probably don't have to roll for that. Between all of you, I think you all have your own sources of light.
Lighten this bitch up.
Hell yeah.
Hey, boys, time to light up. Well,
not far into the cave, you do. You are stopped by your first roadblock. A big metal old world door, by the looks of it.
Oh, I'm just gonna kick it down.
Now, there are small holes that the whatever pests were stealing the food, they managed to find their way around.
I'm not big enough for
all of you.
I'm stronger. I'm going to kick the door down.
I did say I was going to kick down the door, though.
Hey, guys, so what happens to knocking?
Let me give it just one attempt, please, to kick down the door real quick.
I'll let you, whoever wants to, attempt to kick down the door with brawn and melee.
Okay,
ooh,
here we go.
It's a different type of knocking.
Just keep in mind, this is, like, raw metal.
I didn't even think I'd succeed. That was kind of the point. So, like, I give it, like, a really solid kick.
Just, but mine's just better.
That is true.
Well, mine is just a kick, really.
I forgot to label each of yours. Dex.
Our
your
spec.
Crit is 3, so that's, what, 5 successes for the hard light sword and one...
No, figure. I punch it down.
Oh, you're punching it down. Okay.
Yeah.
So. I pushed it up for you.
Well, I will say, your punch does do a lot. So it's pretty much off its...
Does it kind of just go flying, like, off its hinges? Like
that one punch puts a huge dent in the door, enough to where Billy's a lot more pitiful in comparison.
I was thinking even that, you know, I just ran up to it and kicked it, and then, you know, since I'm such short stature, he just kind of hit it over my head, and I just thought that I did that.
You definitely got the bulk of the work done, but Billy's kick did assist in getting it over one little rock block in the way.
Well, the handle's right there, but that's one way of getting through.
Hey,
and with that, the door's open.
I'm gonna put a hand on Cyan's shoulder, and I'm just gonna be like, "Hey, pal, you know, why don't you take point for whatever rabbits or whatever are in this cave, huh?"
Of course.
I don't know why you're saying that. I did all the work. I'm gonna just start walking straight through the door.
I'm gonna walk ahead of Billy Starfield.
I will say, For those walking ahead, you do notice a few small rodents with what looks like some scraps of what was taken. They're very hunger panged, skinny.
Mating space rabbits! I make a run for it.
I stand my ground and pull out the hard light sword and shield.
Yeah, they also look nothing like rabbits.
I hide behind Cyan.
Are these things like the size of rats, or are they like...
Yeah, like a bigger rat.
Cyan, be careful.
No, they aren't immediately aggressive.
But not too careful!
Yeah.
Nah, these things eat men.
Yeah.
They aren't immediately aggressive, but they are pulling the spoils further ahead while eyeing you up cautiously, should you come any closer.
I'm going to try to scare him off. I'm going to run him with my arms flailing. Like this.
Ah!
Like that.
Like that.
It's a technique I was taught by the president of space.
Okay. So running forward screaming. Mm-hmm. I suppose that would be maybe agility perform.
I'll round it out.
Agility performed.
Oh, no.
First Joker of the
first Joker of the series. Let's go.
Here we go. Now, well, they didn't see you as a threat initially. They certainly do now. And your screaming has alerted a couple more of them.
Ah, amazing space rabbits!
I say, from amidst them.
I will say, one of them does run off into a direction that you keep note of for once you are out of this pickle.
Don't worry, guys. I think I scared. I think I shook him up a little bit.
Oh yeah, yeah! You shook him up like a hornet's nest.
They're not hornets. They're man-eating space rabbits.
I've been told.
And with that, I guess
they're hungry for flesh, and all they're gonna feel is my hard, light steel.
I guess this is the first combat.
Hell yeah.
Fuck yes.
My initiative is 3. I'm just throwing that out there to Zelda to keep in mind.
Oh, my initiative is 3. My initiative
is 3. You have to turn this down.
Yep.
Wait, is this an order, Zell? Like from highest to lowest? Like what Dingle did in Heroes?
Yeah, highest to lowest.
Yeah, that thing I totally did in Heroes, right?
Wait, didn't you do that?
Maybe on accident, but I definitely didn't try to.
I think we reorganized it at some point.
Oh, wait, no, I did not. I did not organize it, so, sorry, no.
I'm in general.
I thought
you just meant general. Combat is in order from highest to lowest, which is how combat works. No, Billy and Voltage are tied for...
Time to settle.
Okay, I got a coin.
I'm settled this.
Would you like to do a one and done settling?
Yeah, one and done
ceremonial.
Classic.
All right.
Face me, coward. Oh fuck.
Let's go, baby.
If you want, you can shovel it back in, or you can just live with it.
Nah, I'm keeping that bitch out. I don't need that failure.
You know what? It's a tempting offer, but yeah. It's a tempting offer, but I think I will keep that non-success out of my deck.
Fair enough. That's how we will rule this from now on, then.
He is max voltage.
This is true.
I didn't finish the design in time, but he's got lightning on his clothes, guys. That makes him extra fast.
Hey, that is true.
Who?
You are faster than your local geriatric.
Alright. So these things are, so you said these things are like the size of rats?
They're a bit bigger, but not, they're noticeably...
Maybe, so like a New York City rat.
Sure.
Like,
one of them is taking a shower.
Yes! Don't kill that one!
Maybe like the size of a football, but bigger.
Okay, that still works for what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna have Rhodey create like, just like a solitary, just like bass drum, just sort of like at my feet, and I'm gonna kick it and try and roll over the rat nearest to me.
Okay, so you want to like roll over it like?
It's like. It's on its side in front of me, just sort of like, you know, not like attached to a drum kit.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
I'm just gonna like kick it to roll it into and over one of these things.
Okay, yeah, so trample damage. Now. Alright, so we rolled that as what was your instrument based attacks. And it was like brawn and perform for your instrument based melee, right?
I think so, yeah.
Trample is based.
Trample is based.
All right. Hey. You know what?
Put some drive on it.
Give me a drive.
Hey, listen. You know, if you need
one more,
you know,
put some drive on it.
There you go.
Let's go.
Which one would you like to trample?
This guy right here seems like the closest to me.
I will say, he does go down in the one hit.
Hell yeah.
Oh, bravo, Sonny. What a performance.
I just cartoon flattened the space man-eating space rabbit.
See, they're not too tough, guys. We're pretty strong, okay? I don't think
many space
rabbits can take us down.
Yeah, I sort of turn to the group and I'm like, yeah, these guys actually suck. I didn't think that would work, so we're good.
Hey, we'll all have our badges from the President of Space soon.
Yeah, that's right. I'll let him know about your brave and heroic act. But we're going to need a spaceship first.
With that, it is Billy's turn.
Oh, man, okay.
All right,
you've got two next to you.
This is a little difficult now. Okay, I got an idea. Okay.
Like how you use 20 of your fucking darts already.
I'm gonna take my spash off and I'm gonna choke one out.
Alright. Choke one out. Sounds like another. That does sound like another prawn melee, looking at your sheet here.
I was thinking.
Yeah, I guess you do have drive.
I
feel like garroting a rat with a fucking handkerchief is definitely brawn melee.
Dude. Alright, we're gonna keep it going. I'm just gonna slap. Oh, fuck. Oh, jeez.
Oh, there you go.
Okay, well.
Which one would you like to
Well, I was running around screaming, so I'm thinking the one furthest away from me.
The one all the way back here?
Yeah.
Okay.
Looks like I'm still running around screaming.
Okay.
And maybe not so much a groat, maybe more of like a towel whip.
Towel whip, okay.
Well, just because, yeah.
And with that,
yeah, let's get them, boys.
With that, it goes to the rats.
Oh shit!
I say rat. They are unspecified.
We just got the rat music on, dude.
The fucking rat track.
Right. I will say, Billy, you take one damage.
Oh, is it dodgeable?
It is dodgeable.
I just, I heaved myself out of the way.
Yeah.
I kind of stumble on the fourth, and it doesn't hit me.
With Cyan.
How many?
With that, it goes to Cyan. The other ones, they did not roll so well.
They try to bite at your ankles, but they can't get through the armor.
Yeah.
They
are noticeably weak.
Which one's less weak?
The one that he just attacked.
Yeah, smacked it with my sash.
Yeah.
Cyan's gonna just rush towards the nearest one and take a slash at it.
Fair enough. I think you know what that one is.
Brawn melee, the classic.
We got an expert over here.
We got some kind of fucking brawn melee over here.
Man, that's a lot of bunk cards.
You really were the brawn melee all along.
I mean, there's always.
By the way, I forgot. Brown brought it up earlier, but. I don't know if people actually knew what he was talking about.
Oh, shit.
Me and Brown both have the ult Simpatico.
Oh,
so
yes. Okay.
If you want to use some of, either of our drive, just ask.
Oh, I have the thing that I gain drive every time I get hit, so don't worry about that.
All right. I will say
that is a fun. That is a fun. That is a fun ability.
I will say it's spaced bard fashion. I will create a hard light instrument, and describe playing a little song to aid you.
Hell yeah!
Use my drive.
Nice.
Yeah, two successes. Is that enough to take care of this rat, Zell?
It is very weakened.
Really?
Dude, use your drive, dude.
I'll use one drive. Actually, no, wait. I get drive every time I get hit. I'm using both my drives. There we go.
Oh, yeah. You should absolutely do the fucking fat Pikachu and just bottom out your drive.
Oh, yeah.
Because every time I get hit, I just get more drive.
Every time you get hit, you get two exactly, and I don't think it overcaps you. So
when
you
told me his build, I was like, "Welcome to Fat Pikachu, my dude.
Welcome to the fun. Welcome to Fun Tank.
Fun Tank.
What is it? Bork and fucking the drive.
No, it's called Punching Bag. Brown. Every time I get hit, I get two things of drive.
What's your other alt? Is what I'm saying.
Oh, friendship speed.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
The third friendship speech character.
Oh,
I'm waiting.
He's gonna use it this time.
I'm gonna use it. I'm not using it on the first fight.
For sure.
If I don't, Jingle's gonna call
That's
me
already
out every
a bad
session
track
I don't
record.
Use it.
We're
the second when he
right
showed
now.
when he showed me his sheet, the first thing I said was, "I'm going to call you out every session you don't use friendship speech."
It's gonna be
that was my note.
Hell yeah.
Right. I want to say, I want to cut the rat queen in half, or whatever it is.
The queen?
The clean in half.
Oh, clean in half.
It's
okay.
Like a really clean.
Say, this is
no,
queen
no, no, no. Sorry.
I would also like to cut the rat queen in half, though.
You'll get your chance, but yeah, I'm fine with that.
That's my turn.
That is your turn. On to Cherry.
I'm gonna squeamishly stamp on the whipped rat with my boots.
Alright.
Or whatever fucking Billy did to it. Did you whip it?
I whipped it.
I was gonna grout it, but then the damage is so low. I was like, yeah, I just kinda twist my sash up and fucking give it a towel whip. Let me show you how to done, young whippersnapper.
Alright, I'm gonna squeamishly finish it off. What's the flip?
For a squeamish action, this is easily the most brutal thing. Cyan at least used a weapon.
Boots a weapon.
My Tim's and my Grace's weapon.
I guess in geriatric's hands.
That is true.
What's the flip?
Probably.
Gotta be brawn melee for a rat stomp.
It's the toughest old man I've ever met. Okay,
drive.
You shouldn't be driving at your age.
Oh.
Heyo.
Wait. Yeah.
Wrong.
Oh yeah. They. Nope. You put a new
Me?
Card in there.
Oh, I just stopped talking.
Yeah, maybe I'll let the discard one. Have all of them, but for now, that does indeed finish off this very skinny rat.
Stomp on it. Haven't you seen Oh Shit, It's a Rat? Isn't a boot the best way to deal with it?
Oh shit.
No, my favorite rat related video was fucking this dude who's like, He's like, Casey, have you seen my coffee mug? And then he opens up a cabinet, and there's like a pet rat. It's like a domesticated rat, but he was put there for the video. And he goes, oh fuck, there's a Jew in the cupboard. He pulls out like a revolver.
Oh, that video.
That real bitchy laugh.
Y'all already know my favorite rat video.
Rat chef.
Rat taking a shower, baby.
I don't know.
What?
I have no idea what that
Wait,
is.
What?
Wow. You guys.
Rat taking the shower.
There's no fucking way
on.
I
Never.
Haven't posted this.
Put it in, dude. Slap it in.
Wait, hold on. It's in my fucking.
Imagine it's up to you to intercut rat taking a shower at this point in the video.
It's in my favorite.
Don't
video
worry, I'll do it for him.
Are you editing stuff?
Hell yeah.
I'll do it for him.
I think after
this video unavailable.
After it's a rat. I always think of Rat Chef, dude.
Rat Chef.
I mean, it didn't show up as a.
Oh, you know what? I was trying to take I was trying to take the playlist tag off of it.
Oh.
Is that rat actually taking a shower?
I think he's like trying to rub like oil or something out of this.
No, it's some like weird thing that like that species of rat does. Like that's some sort of like something that like it makes that it uses to clean itself.
Oh, this is a rat taking a shower.
I just love the fucking rain effect and like the little royalty free music while he's taking a shower.
Dude, he's smooth taking a shower, dude.
Oh, and
also, rat, dude.
Also, a fun fact about that video that I didn't find until years later is that the description is psychotic.
Yeah, it is.
Watch. If
I just
got little...
back into play room and the fucking.
I'm sorry. Watch this little rat washes himself in the shower just as a human would. This is the shareable version. If you believe this is animal cruelty, then subscribe to this channel. They started with 2 subs. If you think that people are overreacting, then subscribe to our channel. We started with 16,200 subs.
Oh.
Update. And then last 1,000 subscribers has to leave their channel. Subscribe to both, and you are crazy. To read the full story of this rat, you will need to visit our channel.
To read the full story of this rat! I fucking love it. Okay.
I'm in their channel. It's the Brain RB, South America's number one supporter group. Join us for events all over the world. Or follow us on Facebook.
That was such an adorable little rat shower, dude.
Fucking great video. But anyway,
with that, it does roll back to Max's turn.
So, I'm gonna. All right, let's see. How am I gonna do this one? All right, I'm gonna walk up closer to the rat, and I'm gonna have Rhodey create both an amp next to the rat and a guitar.
Hell yeah.
And I'm just gonna strum out a very loud chord right next right at this rat.
Okay, that is the most brutal thing
that
is.
That sounds like a presence performed to me.
Yes.
Fucking destroy this rat's internal organs through sound. Oh,
the Joker!
Nice!
Very cool.
Now, you are in a very tight cave.
Oh, God!
yeah, your buddies absolutely feel that. And you can hear some rumbling further in, but thankfully this room... it's quite close to the entrance and seems pretty stable.
I just realized that those are 2 separate tokens for you and your robot.
That is.
Yeah, we talked about this.
I might have had my headphones off when you talk.
Yeah. This song plays while the rat final. Gift just
I opened
going.
It up for all cards, so it's fine.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
I'm still going to at least try.
It doesn't really matter.
I'm pissed about it. If I see any of you put it in the wrong discard pile, you're done.
That was 2 successes.
That was 2 successes.
It's definitely feeling the effects. Not far from being taken care of.
All right. What was the effect of the Joker again?
Everyone else also takes damage.
How much?
Oh, shit.
1?
Is it dodgeable or undodgeable?
I'll say 1.
Well, I mean, my dodge is gonna reply after that.
What, it's dodgeable?
Yeah.
No,
is it dodgeable or not dodgeable?
I guess you can't really dodge sound. I'll say 1 undodgeable.
Oh, then I get 2 drive back.
Is that how that works? Is it just whenever you take damage?
Yeah.
During combat, right?
And it's technically during combat, so.
I think it does specify during combat, but that this counts.
No, when you take damage to your health, at least in the one that I.
Oh, neat.
If it's that, then. Ooh, boy.
Just always use your drive for every flip.
That's what I'm going to do. It's going to be nuts.
I kind of hold a hand to my ear and I'm like, Jesus, the acoustics are not great.
Oh, Max,
they're actually fantastic.
That was not your best work.
What? Hey, listen. I mean, you fucking kill a rat.
Hey, Jerry. I was gonna say it's one undodgeable, not two. I think you haven't been attacked.
Oh.
To answer Max Holtage, Ryan literally just goes, I did.
Do you think I can get my deathness badge
now? Well, okay,
but
you know how hard it is.
It wasn't that hard.
What are you guys talking about?
Oh, Jerry, are you okay?
Are you okay, Sonny?
With all of you slightly, with slightly more tinnitus than you had previously.
Is that rat still alive?
Well, yes, barely. It's time for Billy to finish what he very much started.
Also, my ult, when I take damage, the next person to go gets a plus one.
Yes.
Whatever. So, Billy, shit. You got a plus one on the house.
Actually, hold on. Speaking of a plus one, I didn't do my healthy flip, so let me do that really quick. Okay. Doesn't change anything.
Okay.
Changes your damage.
Oh shit. I'm trying to think of how to attack using what I'm skillful at.
How will you get rid of this?
Okay. I just thought about it. Okay, I'm gonna use the secrets the president taught me. I'm gonna pull out my flint and steel and I'm gonna try to light a little campfire under him.
Alright,
You're gonna cook him alive?
I gotta get my fire starting, bed.
Would that be wit? I'm fine with giving you a wit survival for that.
I bet. Look at all this fur go.
With that, I will also say
that was the most psychotic reaction.
Yeah, exactly.
You can also add one extraordinarily rat meat.
Sorry, I had a plus one from Sigrun.
There you go.
Jesus.
Okay.
The rat bar.
Yeah, you can add some extraordinarily lean rat meat to your inventory. That's hey, maybe it'll heal you.
You guys hungry? I eat it. I just eat it. Just kidding, mine. Get out of here.
You eat it? Okay.
I chow down, yeah. Hey, look, guys. See? I told you the president gave me my first starting badge. I'm pretty damn good at it. And now I got some tasty rat.
Well, you just removed the evidence.
Yeah. I'll let you heal the full for that one. I mean, it's only one, you're like...
That's what I did. I'm like, I only got 3 HP anyways. Fuck it.
Not really sure what else I can give you for that crit. Oh, no.
I ate the rat.
Yeah.
And now there's a fire in the cave.
Now there's a fire.
Actually,
there's a flaming rat in the cave.
Let's smoke them out, boys.
I'll say the crit also eliminates the smell that would have arisen. And you don't have to worry about the smoke inhalation.
My small lungs. My poor lungs.
A clean burning rat.
I've discovered a new source of energy.
spell. Gotta switch to you.
Could have gone worse.
Implacable hustle and a Sigma grind set.
But we're no closer to figuring out the source of this rodent problem.
I mean, What? There's no source to a rodent problem. There's just more rats.
Yeah, the source is the rats. Let's burn them all. Burn them all.
I will remind you that on your initial running and flip, you did notice one running.
We should follow that one that ran away.
Oh, right. Yeah. Let's take this.
Did it run like further in, or did it run like in a crack or something?
It took its food that it was holding and ran further in.
Gotta follow it. Let's go.
Is there like a stick around or something?
Cyan's gonna run after it.
Also, I will say none of the rats that you took care of, none of them seem to have taken any bites out of the stolen food.
Oh, we see the bait though.
Yeah. They drop some of it.
I'm gonna take whatever pieces I can find. Put them in my, my handy dandy left hand pocket of my shorts.
You can add some poisoned food to your not useful items.
Oh,
Cyan's running in. By the way,
you'll see.
He's running further in to where the other rat ran away from.
All right. As you run further in, you do notice what probably caused, or something that was probably caused by the large sound you heard earlier in a large stalactite falling into, or that had fallen into. Into a gap in the ground. So there are a couple more chasms or stalactites ahead, but the gap is noticeably smaller than it was before. Now that you can walk on top of one of them,
can I just like walk over the gap, or do I need to jump over?
I'm gonna throw a rock at another stalactite.
Can you please let me get an answer, Brown?
You can attempt to jump over. It's pretty far.
Cyan's gonna kind of go for a running jump, but at the last second, his metallic like armored boots are gonna kind of. They're gonna have like little. They have little thrusters on the bottom. They're more for long jumps rather than actually sustained flight, though.
Fair enough. Sounds like an agility athletics.
Okay. Gonna use my drive. There we go.
No, you absolutely make it over the gap. However, you still have three teammates who are noticeably not.
So, you said the gap was pretty long.
Pretty long.
All right.
Wait, okay. Is there like a...
Okay, hear me out. hear me out. I want to try and you can definitely make me flip for this one, because I'm abusing the hard light creation. I want to see if I could get get Rhodey to make one of those like big long sort of like those like floor pianos that you'll see in like malls and shit that like kids can like step on. I want to see if I can bridge the gap with that.
I was going to say, is there like a stalagmite or a stalactite, whatever, on my side that I could like push over, kind of like when you push a tree over like a chasm?
There are a few more stalactites on this.
Any that would cross the gap, that would like make the gap.
Yes.
Can I try pushing one over?
They are on the ceiling.
Oh, never mind. I thought they were.
But if you have a wave.
I don't. I only have my sword.
I was going to throw rocks at him, but I definitely want to see what happens when Dingle
right, tries
piano to make a giant
floor piano. Is the only solid...
I guess the question begs, can the hard light instruments stay suspended in midair?
Oh, no, they can't. That's what I was trying to
you
make.
You wanted, like, a really
that's
long...
That's what I was trying
yeah,
to make sure that was really
big. Like,
okay, I start throwing rocks.
Big enough to where... It'd be a long jump, but it's doable.
Okay.
I feel like that's big player piano, or yeah, big pianos are probably on that. I could give you it.
I'll try to bridge the gap a little bit then with, you know, tossing the rocks, dude, at stalagmites.
I could give you it as like, if it's like balanced precariously, but. You can also try to throw the rock.
Let's see what the rock throw does.
That's what I was thinking. Like maybe if we like bridge it up just a bit more, then we'd be better space for floor pianos. I cannot believe that's where you went with that.
I needed a musical, because it has to be a musical instrument, but I wanted something big enough to bridge the gap, so I thought one of those, like, fucking, the big keys that kids can jump on, like Mall of America.
Yeah.
I like where you're going with it. I do. It's on a rock. That sounds like a witty enough solution. It'd still be firearms, which you would have none of.
Hell yeah. Oh, well, who cares? So it was wit, you said?
Yeah.
And firearms. Very, very bad throw. I have very weak arms.
You absolutely do not hit the stalactite.
It just falls into the chasm. Like, it just loses momentum halfway through.
Yeah, I actually skipped a rock throwing training because I had to get out, do jobs for the president too quickly. I was kind of needed elsewhere before I kind of figured that out. So I'll let you guys handle this.
Don't have that bad.
Yeah, just sit on the ground. I play on my phone, I guess.
Okay. I like the rock throwing idea. Can I try and fucking? I want to make I want to make like a cello and the thing that you use to sort of like play it.
It's called a bow.
And I want to pull it back on one of the strings like a bow and shoot the little player thing at a stalactite.
Absolutely.
Yeah, the thing that you're talking about shooting is actually called a bow.
Is it called a bow? I didn't know.
I said that.
Yes.
One.
I said it.
I did.
I didn't hear it. I must have missed it.
I feel like that also sounds like a wit firearms.
Okay.
It's a pretty similar idea.
I just love... There's just something about the saying firearms for doing like a ranged attack that makes me so happy.
Jesus Christ.
Well, so you're... as you're loading your bow into your makeshift bow, it is absolutely rubbing against the cello's strings and makes a very sharp noise, which does in turn agitate the cave and stalactites a bit. Enough to make it so that when your little projectile does hit, it does fall into the chasm. However, there are also many small rocks above you falling as well.
God damn it.
Just max or...
I'd say everyone give a single card.
I mean, can't I use my hard light shield as like an umbrella from it?
Sure.
Well, maybe flip a card and see.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
You are safe.
They maybe maybe cool it on the rock and roll there a little bit.
It's one dodgeable for.
Oh, dodgeable.
Or, I guess it's. I mean, rocks are. Yeah, you know what? I'll keep the Joker's arm.
All right.
I think it's probably good to keep some consistency.
Wait, so is the cousin? Is there a path now?
There is a path. It's still got some gaps you need to jump over, but it's not nearly as much of a feat.
I do have my jumping badge, so I will hop along.
I just want to say for the record, that would have happened no matter how we brought the ceiling down. We were literally shooting things off the ceiling.
Yeah. Buddy, trying to get us all killed in this, you know, cave full of killer rabbits from space.
Hey, at least I hit mine.
Hey, listen, I told you, I haven't gone to the proper training yet. I've had too many important missions. Buddy?
The cave shakes a bit as you continue your yelling.
All right, needless to say, I am hopping over as well.
Right. Yeah, so.
Actually, I write numbers on each stalagmite as I go across it, so it's easier for them to hopscotch across.
Like the gap's short enough that it's fine to assume you make it across safely.
Did the geriatric come with us?
Oh, yeah.
With that, as you continue on your path, there is that rodent that you saw. Well, presumably that rodent you saw get away earlier. Looks like he's carrying the same sort of deal. Similar situation to the first, where he's still not immediately aggressive, but he's definitely keeping an eye on you.
I run at him with vengeance in my eyes.
And there are significantly more of them up ahead in front of it.
I stop running.
Wait. Billy, didn't you grab that food?
What?
Didn't you pick up food from the other?
Didn't pick up whistle food.
I'm not going to use it right now. What am I going to do with it? They weren't
throw
even
it at
eating
the rats,
it.
And if some rats eat them, then they die of poison, right?
Okay, I'll throw a piece into the horde of rats.
Make sure it's a big enough piece for some of them to share.
A fat, juicy chunk.
How many are there?
Maybe like, let's say six.
Oh, and you know what? Since they're space rabbits, I'll also I'll take off a badge that has a carrot on it from like my gardening badge. And I'll slap that on the piece of meat just so like they'll be more drawn to it since they're rabbits.
You know what? I think since you're throwing it, it'd probably be brawn. But since this is luring in animals, I'll give you survival for the secondary.
Okay. Yep. Yeah.
Do you want me to try?
Actually, no. I'm like, hey, Max, play a little ditty for me.
Yeah, what kind of music? I was thinking the same thing, but I don't know what kind of music rats like.
They like royalty-free music.
Well, no, aren't you just...
Like, while they're especially while they're showering.
Oh, you're right. I'm going to play the fucking rat showering song and try and soothe them.
Yes. Yeah, get them a little hungry. Yeah, get them relaxed. Now, how much of your drive can I steal, Dingle?
Let's see what you flip first.
Okay, we'll do it one by one. Bad.
Oh, wait. I have to flip too, right? To play the song?
Yes.
Yeah, you're playing a hard light flute, right?
No, this is a recorder.
This is like Pied Piper.
It's definitely a recorder. What is it? It's obviously performed, but what else?
I feel like, in my opinion,
if I can give my two cents, not trying to lawyer it, I feel like playing instruments is generally like a presence action.
Yeah, I was gonna say the same thing.
All right, I'm not
none of the others really seem to fit as well.
Not healthy anymore. Ooh.
Yo.
God, this is such a banger song as well.
5-6 successes.
That is, I think, 6, yeah.
Wait,
what the fuck?
Yep, it is 6.
Fucking rad song, man.
So wait, is
encore,
crit,
encore.
Is 6 by itself? Or is that
no,
it together?
My crit is 4.
Yeah.
So
okay.
It's 6 total.
6 successes. All right. What happens?
I bang out the rat showering song on my recorder on a hard light recorder.
Fuck. Dude, I'm playing again. Fuck.
Loop that shit until the crowd does his action.
How many more can I flip? Did I already stole one of your drives and failed horribly?
Oh, give me. All right. Take 2 more. I got 6.
All right, dude. I bet. Nice, dude.
Alright, well, somehow they do, in fact, really love this particular style of music. And it leads them right to the bait meat that you threw very short in front of you.
Hey guys, I forgot I can't throw.
In between beats, I'm kind of like, what are you doing? I gotta turn down.
Yeah, fair enough. There's a big difference between the battle and the ambient.
So we're fighting the 6 rats now?
I was gonna say, they grab, not only do they grab the bait meat that you failed to throw, they grab the bait food from your pockets as well.
Aww.
Yeah, but it's got poison on it. If they eat it, they're just gonna die.
They don't, however, eat it.
Why not?
They just need to be taking it somewhere.
Did they just run away?
They're not running away, but they're dragging it along, to somewhere else.
Why don't we just follow them and see where it leads?
Ah, man-eating rabbits! I start swinging.
Why don't you just...
They're all over me, dude. They're in my fucking pockets.
They are in our pockets, right? They are, like, crawling on us right now.
Yeah.
On me?
They're definitely crawling on him.
Oh, because he's the only one who had the food, right?
Yeah, I put all the bait in my pocket.
Billy, stand still. And Sion's going to draw his sword.
I'm swinging. I'm freaking the fuck out. I'm a astronaut hired by the president covered in rats.
I think this situation does justify the battle music.
I'm going to very precisely slash at the rats on Billy's body. With my sword.
While I'm flailing around madly.
Yes.
That still sounds like grunt melee.
I'm going to shield Rhodey's eyes preemptively. Or eye, rather, I guess.
I'll say there's good luck.
Oh?
Yeah,
oh,
dude.
Three of them on you.
Fucking fuck,
another 2.
I was kind of partly hoping for that because Brown was getting on my nerves.
Oh, rude!
You've been rude this whole time, interrupting
you,
people.
You've been rude this whole time, cynical. How about that?
Nah.
And I haven't said nothing about it.
Alright. Okay. I feel like this one's pretty straightforward with you slashing at your friend.
Hitting gets some successes in all fairness.
Yeah. It does also it does also hit the rat, but he is definitely attached to the rat.
And vice versa.
Yeah. I'll say it takes out one of them. But...
some rat patrol out here, am I right? Up top.
Up top. Gotta have more rats.
Nobody gets it when I do a rat patrol joke.
Wait, did you already take a rat off the off belly?
I did take one.
Okay.
Wait, did I take damage?
Yeah.
One or two. Bruh.
That's the question, isn't it?
You don't gotta go.
I only
easy
rolled
on
one joke.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll save one. Also.
Well, you did get two sixes, that's what I was asking.
And you are still coming.
I'm pretty much the most useful member of this team, I'd say.
You were the rat bait all along.
Just gonna
sorry, Billy.
Like, man, we could have chosen any other job.
Yeah, but what was the guy's name who hired us?
It was Glenn Hoffman.
Glenn Hoffman. Shopkeep. Yeah, Glenn Hoffman's the local shopkeep. He's our friend, dude.
Okay. Yeah, he's
the
a good
local
guy.
Shopkeep of the planet we're trying to get off of.
Yeah, but I mean, you can't forget, you know, where you're from. You know what I mean? I mean, not that I'm from here. You know, I'm from the stars, as they say. I was hired by the president of space.
I don't know where I'm from.
Okay, unless Zedrin's got something, I've got an idea.
Go ahead.
Are those... So how many rats are there
two.
On him?
I said
just the two?
Six earlier. There were three on him, three up ahead. The one's up ahead. So,
okay.
Are eyeing you up.
I'd like to make two of those like little like shell clacker things and use those to grab the rats so I don't actually have to touch them.
The castanets.
Oh, castanets or whatever.
Yeah, I don't know what they're called.
Absolutely.
Some musician.
Honestly, not knowing what they're called, I think is on brand for my character's background.
True. What are you trying to do with them?
Yeah!
I'm just trying to grab the rats, but they're more here so I don't have to touch them with my bare hands.
Okay. Yeah, it sounds like a wit perform. To play the castanets with some rats inside.
Play the ratsanets.
Ratsanets.
Nice, up top of that one, dude.
Hell yeah, dude.
Ratsanets, dude.
You are now holding two ratsanets.
What are you gonna do with your new pets, Max?
Yeah, funny. I'm throwing them away and having the and making the castanets get unmade.
Yeah, fair enough.
So all that's left is those ones up on the up ahead.
Where exactly are you throwing them?
Sort of away from myself. Just kind of lobbing them away with the castanets.
Okay.
You hear like the noise.
Yeah,
rats
make they kind of scurry off, but they take the L on that one.
You're just going hard, and all we're doing is fighting rats.
the man-eating space rabbits. Thank you very much.
Well, with that, it's Billy's turn again. Should he decide? I guess technically you're out of combat, but I don't know if you want to change that.
But so the rats are the last couple are just chilling up ahead. I thought they ran off.
They were eyeing you up before they go back to taking the food wherever they were going.
Okay, this time I'm gonna try to scare them off again with my classic technique of running at them and screaming while singing the national anthem of space.
Could you stop doing that?
What?
Did you just stop screaming at them?
I got this. Oh, say, can you see by the star-spangled space what so proudly we...
Because you space. Are one intelligence, I almost want to give you an intelligence flip for that. But I'll let it be the presence perform.
Hello, that wouldn't have been so
I won't flip for I won't flip for this because I'm not trying to I'm not trying to augment the flip, but I will play a backing track to him yelling the Star Spangled Space Banner.
Okay, so how much your drive can I steal?
Dude, you gotta flip first, man.
Oh shit.
Oh. See?
Four successes.
I don't even think I speak.
I'm gonna drive, I gotta update it.
Yeah, you're right, dude, you're right. I wasn't thinking.
The rest of the rats definitely scurry off.
I turn back with my hands on my hips and I say, yeah, most man-eating space rabbits are scared of patriotism. It's well known in the stars. I got this badge for.
Seems like they run off into a slightly brighter lit opening.
Billy, that looks like a cooking badge.
Yeah, and? What's your point? It might look like that, but it's kind of like secret code, you know, covert special ops. You wouldn't really understand our methods.
Covert, huh?
Mm-hmm.
It shows.
Keep moving forward, I guess.
I'll say two of them dropped the poison meat if you want to replenish your stocks.
Yeah, I picked that shit back up. This time I put it in different pockets, though, so they don't all go into one. Because I kind of like the smell.
Fair enough. So, if you are following Cyan's idea of pushing forward.
Continuing on.
You enter the slightly brighter lit room now with what appears to be an opening to the surface and the ceiling far above. But this vast room, most notably, is covered in a lot of scrap and just other junk collected on the ground, presumably from the rats over the years. And in the middle is a very, very large rat towering over all of you.
Oh, shit.
Most notably, not hunger-panged like the rest.
I think we found our source.
Told you there was a source.
Yeah.
Just figure a speech. We're still killing rats, like I said.
I lean over to Cyan and I say, I thought you already cut the rat queen in half.
That was not a character mispronounced.
Space rabbit.
That was an out-of-character mispronunciation. I didn't say that in character.
What does that mean? What is out-of-character?
Brown, I'm talking to you.
Who's Brown?
Please stop.
moving on. Yeah. This giant rat seems to be the one who's been taking all the food for its stuff.
Oh. Compared to the exploits of the legendary space hero, this thing is nothing.
Nah, I got this. Hey, big rat, I think you should stop taking the food of the local village. It's quite unbecoming of you, actually. I very much appreciate if you stop.
Kind of rolls over in your direction and just kind of like makes a noise.
Does it open its mouth?
Reaches.
I immediately hide behind Scient.
Sword and shield is already out at this point.
Does it open its mouth?
It does open its mouth.
I'm putting the meat in, dude. I'm meeting it up.
Okay. How exactly would you like to put the meat in?
Don't you mean throw it in?
You know, well, I have my animal husbandry badge, so I'm just gonna walk up to it with the meat in my hand, and I'm gonna let it, you know, be gentle.
It's gonna bite your entire arm off.
I'm just gonna put the meat in its mouth.
What fucking role is that?
Charm and
survival?
Yeah, I'd say our charm and survival. Yeah.
Classic charm survival flip. Okay, that's one. And then two. There you go, buddy.
Okay.
You hungry?
Wait, what did he get? I wasn't looking.
Two. Two successes.
Two successes? Oh,
two successes.
Not bad.
That's better than nothing, I guess.
Yeah. Well, you are offering him food, so he's wary. That's exactly what he's been looking for.
I'm also whistling the rat song underneath my breath.
I was about to say, seeing an opportunity to get away with this without fighting a giant rat, I will begin playing the rat song again.
Oh, so you want me to steal your drive again?
No, I'm gonna start playing the fucking. I'm gonna start playing the song that I know the rats like from earlier.
Hell yeah!
That'd be another present.
We're jamming.
Hell yeah.
Its guard is super let down. And, for now, it trusts you. It trusts you enough to not sick its rats on you. But,
and maybe, you know, maybe people and man-eating space rabbits can be friends. You guys ever think about that?
Did you feed it the meat already?
He did.
I'm petting it now.
That being said, there are still rats heading up to the up and out to the surface and vice versa, bringing and looking for food.
Is there like a ton?
Oh my god.
Say maybe like. Maybe like seven at the most at a given time. They're in and out type of deal.
I take out the small explosive device I had hidden in my bag.
Seems to last long when they're not exactly getting a fair portion. Pardon? What was that?
Sorry, I said I pull out the small explosive device I had hidden in my back pocket. I was just joking. I was making a joke.
I mean, as the rats keep stealing the food, we can't just let this happen. What do we do from here?
I wanna. I'm gonna very slowly, like, once I'm done playing the song, I'm gonna very slowly walk over to Cyan and just sort of whisper, "Now's your chance."
Cyan jumps at the Rat Queen, sword in hand, for a preemptive attack.
All right. Sounds like a brawn melee. I'll give you plus. I'll give you like plus two for that, for charming and feeding it beforehand. It's super unsuspecting. Oh.
Well, I mean, I knew there was another one in there.
Yeah.
That was rough.
That's a lot of bum cards. What the fuck?
Almost like the you're majority doing big of the flips. Deck.
How exactly do you want to attempt this? Let's say.
Well, he went for a running sword jump and just kind of slash at its head.
Okay. Well, the running sword jump, you know, it does hurt it. It's a decisive blow, to say the least. It's still standing in there, but so is your sword.
I'm gonna pull it out. Shit.
And the rats are probably a bit less happy with you for attacking.
Can I pull the sword out?
They're front. You can try to on your next turn, I'd say.
Oh wait, I can turn off the hard light and it just becomes the handle.
Hmm.
It's not a physical sword.
I feel like what Zell was trying to say was the sword got stuck in his head and you got bucked off of him.
Oh. Is that what you were saying, Zell?
It wasn't originally, but I can play it either that way. If you want to keep your sword, it's going to be not turning on like it normally would until you can figure out what's happened to it. Whichever you want to play for more. Either.
Oh, I thought it was on. It was on, and then I got thrown off the rat, so it's stuck in there. It's stuck on. Like, it's stuck in its neck. That's what I think.
I didn't think about you turning it off. So, originally, it was just you on there with it stuck. But either way, it'll
but
be
I bad. Mean, if it, I mean, if it, it makes things, I mean, because I gotta be honest, I got jokered, so it'd make things too easy if I could just press the button.
Yeah, let's say it bucks you off. You'll have a, you will have a penalty to your melee flips until you can get it back. Say minus two, let's say.
All right, then I'll just have to punch it to death. So I guess this is the fight officially starting.
I guess so.
Also, I just realized, who put that there? Is that the rat from Germa's rat movie?
Yes, it is.
That is
as
the
well
best...
as the little ones, Photoshop to be thin.
That is the best. I love the rat movie.
And some rats who were around do come knock.
Was that you, Dangle, or is that you, Zell?
Oh, that was me. I set that up beforehand.
I love the low poly rats from that Movie Maker game.
It's great. And that's first.
So I guess we gotta do proper turn order now.
First goes Dangle.
I'm just gonna kind of look like. Really? Like a running plunge? Not like cutting its throat or something?
I tried cutting its throat. We see how tall it is?
It's not heroic enough.
Okay. So. You know, it hurt, you know, it hurt the last one pretty bad, and we're in more of an open space that where the ceiling won't really cave in. I'm gonna fucking blast this thing with a fucking guitar chord.
This has worked out very well so far.
To be fair, it's a lot more open, and there's an exit to the innocent. So it's not totally reverberating in, back into your eardrums.
Yeah, thank God. It's only partially a bad idea now.
That was two total.
That's two successes.
Yeah. Well, you know what?
Yeah, it's definitely wincing, and I'll say it's lowering its head a bit.
All right. I guess it's the old-fashioned way.
And with that goes to Billy. Who is directly in front of the rat.
Oh, man, yeah, I'm in a bit of a rough spot here. I mean, I guess I'm just gonna, I don't know, like... just, like, poke it in the eye with a pocket knife or something. Not really much else to do in this sort of situation.
If that's what you want to do, that would be Braun Melee.
Okay, Braun Melee. Okay.
Good.
Yeah, I'm going to run away.
Braun, well, can your character not, like, cannot fight at all?
Yes.
Not with the way he's been
attacking. Oh, okay.
So I'm just doing what my character would do. That's all. Sorry.
Is it my turn? Yet?
Now it is the rat, the small rat's turn.
Damn it.
We'll see. I guess I should probably pull this.
See, I think the roughest part about it is I can't really lie to rats, you know what I'm saying?
I mean, you might be able to if you understood rat.
Yeah, that is true. Now I gotta remember if the president taught me rat.
Alright, so, seeing your, I'd say one of them each goes for each of you. The one running for Billy doesn't quite reach him as he was retreating.
Wait, how much do we take any damage? What's going on?
One damage incoming for Jerry and Max, and then two incoming for Cyan.
Wait, my ultimate works when I take damage, like, not, it's not every hit I get drive, it's every time I take damage.
Every time you take damage.
Okay, so I at least still get 2 drive out of it.
Yeah. You are no longer healthy, I believe, though.
I thought I wasn't healthy at 8.
3, 6, 9.
Oh. Yes, and thirds.
Quarters. Well, if it's in thirds, then he's right.
It is thirds, right? Is it?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah,
eight is a 4 bronze cutoff for healthy.
You are right.
You're officially injured.
I'm still healthy.
Never laugh at the DM, dude.
Is it my turn yet, Zo?
It is now your turn.
I'm going to run at the Queen Rat, and I'm gonna grab the sword, but I'm not gonna do anything. What I'm gonna do is I'm going to, with my momentum for running, I'm gonna upper punch the Rat Queen, Like, just in the lower jaw.
I'll try and, like, dislodge it.
Also, just do a bunch of damage if I can get enough, if I can get enough strength in.
Yeah, yeah, for that. That'd be brawn melee minus 2.
Okay, brawn melee minus 2. So if it's usually 8.
6.
Then it'd be 7, because I do get a plus 1 because I'm healthy.
Yes.
So I get 7. Okay, hold on.
It's plus 1 for health.
Yeah, okay. So that's 2. And now 5 cards.
More.
Plus another 1 because I just took damage.
That is true.
On the
house. And I was going to use my 2 drive anyway.
Yeah, hell yeah. The drive in there too.
Another Joker?
Oh.
What the fuck? What kind of
Yeesh.
What kind of shit is this?
Zell, you get to deal your first double Joker.
Oh, damn.
Man,
make it special.
Well,
they don't come around often.
As it was lowering its head, you do uppercut directly into its mouth.
Alright. Then I just want the visual of, like, his leg sticking out, like when the giant frogs eat the characters in Konosuba.
Except this time it's a giant rabbit, which is very similar to a frog.
Yes.
Just without the fur and ears.
Exactly.
No, but I just want the funny visual of, like, his legs, like, flailing about.
Absolutely.
He coulda fucking cut its throat.
Oh. And with that, it goes to Sherry.
I know somebody's not getting their throat cut in bed.
Wait.
With that excellent series of turns.
Yeah, this is incredible.
Did I take any damage, Zell?
What sign doing
double
right
Joker,
now?
Maybe 2.
So I'm now at 7, but I get my 2 drive back.
What's Sion doing right now?
He is inside of Rat's mouth.
Currently...
Were you not listening, Zed?
He's probably bracing himself, his arms, against, like, the rows of rat teeth to keep him from swallowing him.
I really am.
If I had to guess what he's doing right now.
I'm gonna pick up the closest tiny rat with my gloves and throw it at the big rat. Free him.
Okay. That sounds like brawn firearms to me.
Jerry, can you not fight?
Hopefully you don't throw better than I can.
Rats.
You can absolutely throw better than you can.
Or can he?
A little bit.
In theory.
Oh, drive it up.
Okay.
All right. Zedjin, by the way you were talking about your character, I thought he was going to have like a slew of homemade gadgets or something.
Oh my god.
He might have some stuff up his sleeve.
Not anymore, he does it.
He might have some rats up his sleeve.
Although they call it up his sleeve.
I mean, you see a rat, you can use as a projectile. Can't really say no.
This is the worst team ever.
As you are bending down to pick up that rat, the other rat next to you does run up your sleeve. You are able to get the throw off, however.
Does the throw achieve anything?
It should just like make a squeak. It makes like a fucking like chew toy squeak, like as it just bounces off the big rat.
I'll say it does some damage. Not quite as effective as
by the way, I want to remind the visual that not only is Sion being eaten by this thing, the sword is still stuck in the rat's throat. So it's just all over.
With that, it is now the giant rat's turn. Who,
the rat?
Well, you're in his mouth, so he doesn't really have to deal with you. Is his thought process. But he will slowly... Oh, don't forget to... I think you used some drive, right, Jerry?
Oh yeah.
He will lurch a bit forward and swing as much of its red arm as it can towards you, Jerry.
Do we have a healer on our team?
For
I'm a little bit.
And it will do one damage, dodgeable to both you and Lorette in your sleep.
I use it as a meat shield from within my arm.
Why is there a rat in his sleeve?
Well, he bent down to pick up the other one and plant him.
Oh, nice.
And with that, back to Max.
Okay. How do you get a giant rat to open its mouth?
Oh, dude, cough syrup.
Ah, yes.
Oh, why didn't I think of that?
a big, like car jack. Oh, dude, an accordion.
Accordion like a car jack.
How is an accordion like a car jack? Classic riddle.
Watch it. I wonder if I was trying to force it open, do I even have anything to like? Is there any way to even like get between its rows of teeth?
No, you see, because when an accordion's deflated, it's flat, and then when it's inflated, bam.
I'd say that depends on what you're making.
Whether or not you guys open up the mouth, I got ideas regardless. I just move it along.
You know what? You know what I'm actually going to try to do? I'm gonna try to take my own advice, and I'm gonna grab the sword and see if I could maybe like finish the job. Which I imagine is brawn. I don't have melee, so I'll use my last drive.
Also, you get plus one from me.
Oh, I do. That's right, because you're injured.
Woo! Nice, dude.
I grab the blade and try to like pull it through the like fucking rat flesh it's lodged in. It doesn't budge.
It's like Excalibur, or is it Excalibur?
Excalibur.
Yeah. On the sword in the stone.
Yep.
Yeah.
You'll never be king of England.
Ex-Ratibur.
Not at this rate. Well,
and then
maybe Billy's better at being king of England.
I point to a badge that's got it's a stone with a sword in it. I'm like, come on, bro. You're never going to pull Excalibur out like that. And I just yanked the sword out. You pull it out.
I'm not trying to pull it out. I just want to turn it into a... proper wound. Jesus, that thing is in there way too fucking deep,
dude. All you have to do is press the button. I press the button on the sword.
Yeah, all right. I'll say the sword will retract.
Yeah, and I just kind of. Can I do something else?
Yeah, yeah.
I didn't really flip for that. I'm gonna try to just like toss it into the rat's mouth with Cyan. Yo, heads up! Actually, I'm not gonna toss it. I'm gonna like put it in there. Like, I'm gonna just put it in there.
They don't trust you anymore. You can't just do it that easily.
No, but he's got you in his mouth. It's not like he's gonna just open it up and get me too. You know what I'm saying? I'm just gonna push it in there with you. Because if I try to throw it, I'm gonna fuck it up.
I feel like I feel like that doesn't change your chances.
Okay, so what... Yeah, and...
Looking at your stat sheet here.
What's your point?
I'm saying that'd probably just be brawn melee instead of brawn firearms.
Oh, okay, yeah. Here you go.
Yeah.
I don't even want to attack. I just want to put it in his mouth.
So the Syed can, like, get it.
Yeah, like, I'm pretty sure so I have to jump up there.
Yeah, you can squeeze it in just at the edge.
There you go. I'm gonna back up a little bit after that too.
Little rat's turns.
Also, I'll be right back.
Don't you mean you'll be rat back?
You'll be rat back.
I didn't mean that.
All right, so we got I'll say the one that Jerry threw probably head towards Max as well due to just being closer. No, he probably doesn't want to get thrown again. He doesn't really have enough time to get a full attack in, but the other one will hit you for one dodgeable.
For me?
Yeah.
Okay.
Jerry's rat up his sleeve is still trying to find a good place to chomp down.
It's a very picky rat.
Yeah. Yeah, you'd think he wouldn't be with the help that he's been fed. And then the other rat's coming at Billy for two dodgeable, which I'll subtract for.
It was like vibrating and buzzing and it felt really cool.
I guess Brown doesn't need to be here for Science turn.
Yeah, probably not.
Assume we'll say Cyan is here for Science turn.
Huh? I'm here.
Okay.
So Cyan has a sword back. Huh?
Yeah. Yeah, the sword is like right by the edge of his teeth.
Can I grab it?
You can, in fact, grab it. What would you like to do?
I am now going to push it against the roof of the mat of the rat's mouth. Turn it on and do a big, like, just slash. Just in any direction.
Fair enough.
So is that brawn melee?
That sounds like a classic brawn melee.
Okay.
Uninhibited due to
my sword.
Brawn melee.
Yeah.
Yeah, you took two dodgeable, by the way.
Here we go.
And I'm going to use my two drive. The
and
Joker's
you get a plus one.
And I get a plus one. Oh, well.
Play him a little tune, Dingle. You know you want to.
Okay, Jackson,
You know, I do want to, but since this is happening inside of the rat's mouth, I feel like I don't know what's happening.
You guys, what you will see, if you do want, you will see, like, the sword, like, initially, like, pop up through, like, the rouse, like, the rat's, like, it's, what's
oh,
the,
you,
what's the word
you
for
absolutely,
mouth?
Like, yeah. Turned his head into a Japanese party ball.
Does it look really cool?
What the fuck is a Japanese party ball?
Are you talking about one of those things from Smash Brothers?
Yeah, that's what those are based off of.
You actually hang those from the ceiling, and you pull down, like, a little, like, rope, and it opens up.
Yeah, I hope a Zelda zombie doesn't come out of it.
No, but what is that? That's three.
That's seven
more rats come out.
Yeah, what does it look like, Jackson?
You tell me.
Oh, I don't know. Okay, so shit. Well, I did say like
my idea was the Japanese party ball.
Nah, I want it to be. He pushes up against the roof of the rat queen's like mouth. and does like a vertical slice, like slicing the top of its head clean in half, and then he jumps out of that said hole.
So you're the Japanese party ball, is what you're saying.
Did I kill the rat queen?
I will say the rat queen is decidedly no longer alive.
When Cyan jumps out of the said made like hole, he like lands on top of its body. Like in the highest like point someone could stand up. And he goes, "See? That's nothing for a space hero."
Do that first next time.
I clap.
Woo!
That was so cool, Cyan.
I gotta say, going inside the rat was an ingenious plan. I would have never thought of that.
See, when you're
I knew what you were planning.
See, I learned it all from the exploits of the legendary space hero. You gotta think on your feet. It was my plan, definitely, all along. And it worked
out. Yeah, you can even think when you're off your feet in a rat's mouth.
Yeah. It was nothing. And his cape starts flowing even though there's no wind in the cave.
See, here's how I know that Zell's a nicer DM than me. I absolutely would have made you flip lying there.
Well, now that you mention it.
Damn it! I don't have lying!
Yes! Yes! Being a dickhead.
Fuck you,
yes.
Diggle!
Even when I'm a player! Yes!
do you have persuasion? Yo, you do have. I'll let you do persuasion.
What's the other one? Is it charm? Can I do charm? Because I actually have a point in charm.
Yeah, I'll give you charm.
Charm persuasion, so that's 4.
I get that same feeling, dude.
It kind of works.
Well, it was a pretty heroic act you did.
So, you know, you just let it slide. Max,
wait, what happened?
I kind of technically lied. I got 1 success.
What'd you
but
say?
But because the action was so heroic, you just let it slide.
Okay, fine.
So see, now I'm on top of it.
Now he's on top.
He's on top.
Is Max convinced at all? I don't think he was the only one that wasn't really convinced. With 1 success, is Max convinced?
I mean, if you want to get 1 card, you can put a convinced test, or you can just play it by ear.
I was just asking.
I'll say I'm like half convinced, but it's not worth putting up a stink because he did kill it eventually.
Yeah. He did the most damage.
I like the idea that he doesn't have the body. I always wanted to call Cyan a himbo, but he doesn't have like the actual body for it. But he embodies the spirit of a himbo, where he's really strong and really nice, but his head is full of hair, basically.
Well, the rest of the rats are kind of spooked seeing seeing their leader no longer with them. So they kind of want to get away from you, but with no one to tell them otherwise, now they can eat that poison food.
So we just let nature play itself out.
I put a little plaster in the one on my in my sleeve and then send him off for his final meal.
Aww.
Cyan's cape is still flowing, by the way, but there's absolutely no draft in the cave.
I will say, if that, the problem should probably sort itself out.
What was the shopkeeper's name again, out of character?
Glenn.
Cyan is going to do a front flip and meet the rest of the group on the ground and say, let's report back to Glenn.
Yes,
get our. Let's get our. Let's get paid already.
We'll say, in that opening in the ceiling, there is a what appears to be a broken lift that would go up there.
Can I try pulling the lift? Because I am strong. What do you mean by broken?
Like, it's a mechanical lift, but, with the rats kind of living there, they probably chewed the wires.
What's the point of telling us about this lift? It probably won't move.
I mean, you've got some folks with engineering.
Is it motor based? Is it like a winch?
It's pretty old tech. It's got a motor and a pulley system.
Double Jerry, can you look at this? I can help you.
I've built tree houses before.
I have a thing in engineering. So what do we flip? I'll assist Jerry.
Say intelligence engineers.
Are you going to flip also, Jerry?
Yeah, sure.
I mean, I'm assisting you.
Sorry,
Don't be a geriatric in real life. Only your character.
He had a senior moment.
Yeah. So three successes. Hell yeah. Okay.
You definitely can get this lift up and running. Just a few broken cables. Luckily, you the mechanisms up top were not reachable by the rats themselves. So anything they could reach, so could you.
Good job, Jerry.
Not bad. I'd give you a position in my shop if
we weren't leaving.
If you weren't a legendary space hero.
I mean, once things settle down, I could come back and apply. It's probably a lot of heroing, though.
And with that, I presume you're going to be
leaving.
Leaving
this rat cave.
Heading back to town.
Hell yeah.
To receive your reward next time on RPG.
Damn it! Ooh, he's pulling! He's pulling!
There we go.
Dingle.
There we go.
I know, it's cutting it on the dot there.
This was really good.
This is such dumbass pie, and I'm here for it.
I really like this kind of screen, this one, y'all. That's great.
This party is fucking great.
I've got to say, I've only been Cyan for one session, and I'm already loving how it's turning out. He can both be very useful and very funny. He's very versatile.
Yeah,
I thought I made too many useful characters, so I made one that's like really shit at everything.
You have your moments when you try to.
I was thinking more like just.
You didn't say a lot this session, Zed. Are you okay?
Yeah.
It's pretty late for him.
Damn.
He's an old man. Give him a break.
Is Zed 60 in real life?
Yeah.
Damn.
Do you know?
Yeah, no.
That session kicked ass, though, dude. That was fun.
I'm glad you liked it.
Classic rats, dude. I just fucking love man-eating space rabbits.
And with the rabbit pest out of the way, who are your heroes?
God, I'm just, before we do it, though, I just want to say I'm so freaking pissed, dude, that we didn't get a human interaction this session, dude. I wanted to use that Hail Mary so fucking bad on anything. I just wanted to say something stupid as fuck.
That's what Hail Mary's for.
Yeah, I know, dude. I'm really excited to use it, and I'm bummed I didn't get to this session. Not in like I'm not really pissed about it or anything. I'm just saying, I'm so fucking ready for it.
I got mine picked out easy, so I'll.
All right, Dingle, go first.
Give my hero points for the first time ever, other than as the DM.
Ooh, Zell, do we each get a hero point?
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
Okay, so one's gotta go to Cyan.
Hell yeah.
Carving the shit out of that rat's head.
That was a sick video.
The seven success, like, rat destruction.
Just utterly cleaved him.
Rat.
The other one I gotta give to Billy, though, just because I feel like he initiated most of the, I feel like he was the catalyst for most of our rat encounters this session. I think he really spiced up this fucking rat mission.
That's what makes it more delicious, you know, that little spice.
Just gotta have a little spice. Well, let's add some spice and let's hear what your heroes are.
My heroes for this session? Oh, man. It's definitely gotta be Cyan for just like...
Yeah.
For really just like taking the, you know, the excessive damage I did to the door and just like pushed it that little step further than I needed. And then the other one I'll give to Max Voltage for just the fucking sick licks this entire session.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah. Well, that's, you know, two first I am right here, so... What's next for hero points, Sen?
One to Max, because even if it mostly led to possible failures, the music stuff was really funny, and I think
it was great.
Because Dingle, you're really good as a player. It's really funny.
I'm very excited for this character.
But also, because of that, I like the way that Max and Cyan talk to each other. I think that's going to be a very funny back and forth going forward. And my second one goes to Jerry, because he was just helpful. He was caring. He was helpful. He helped fix the lift.
Lights out.
He threw... I forgot about that. That was a bit gross. But him throwing the rat and that actually doing damage was also really funny.
And putting the rat up your sleeve, obviously.
Yeah. So, one to Max, one to Jerry. Those
I will say favorite. That rat definitely matters.
That was the rat that helped push the finale, like, blow off, like, through the, like, just off the, like, it just
honestly,
pushed it.
Yes.
It pushed it to the finish line. That was so, that's really funny.
The rat chip damage.
The rat damage over time. The rat dot.
R-O-T, rat over time.
Hell. For the rat.
R-A-T, rat over time.
Jerry, who's your heroes?
Definitely gonna give one to... Max for having the getting out the hard light recorder and playing the beat twice. Just a great
moment. Yeah, that's another good reason to give Max the point.
Hey, if I got an audience, I got an audience.
You literally just became the Pied Piper for like a few moments.
And my other one goes to Billy for cooking the rat while it was still alive to make meat, and then
that
immediately eating it.
Oh man,
that's how the president taught me.
I feel like we have to give the anti joker to Dingle.
Yeah, Dingle gets the first anti joker.
That might be dangerous.
I will gladly accept.
No, that may no. Dingle's the most qualified. Brown, he knows. The risks of jokers. He could be like a really good median.
He was, I mean, to be fair, so do we, but.
But I also know. DM. But I also know which jokers will be the funniest.
Yes.
And I will not be shooting them if they're funny.
Respect.
No
that.
Vetoing if it leaves.
Entirely.
I'm glad, like, because, yeah.
I had the
stuff like getting
it.
Eaten by the giant rat definitely shouldn't be vetoed. That's way too funny.
Well, you never know.
Well, okay, if they're like on death's door, then maybe veto them.
I'm so glad someone got eaten by the rat.
Me too.
That was like when we got into that rat encounter and we were feeding it and shit, I was like, this is the perfect way for this fight to go. And it went there.
It was really absolutely. Funny.
I found out today that 10 drive is not as much as I thought.
I really like this.
It goes surprisingly quick. I was shocked how quickly I ate through 9.
Yeah.
That's why you gotta get the punching bag.
What I really want...
I probably did use more drive than you did overall.
Oh, fuck, I forgot to use friendship speech.
Then
you sure did.
To be fair, I was in the rat's mouth. Was I supposed to give a speech?
Yeah.
I used 13 drive this session.
Damn. Alright, well, Dingle, you have your little psychotic Hannibal Lecter, like, counting going. You can scratch off one.
Wait, one.
No. No, I have a fucking construction site. Day is a cynical last. Didn't forget about friendship speech, and I am keeping it at zero.
God damn it. Next session, I'll use it.
Yeah, and then what about the session after that?
I like what Zedj said. He said I should keep not using it. Apparently, it's good for my brand.
It's just you at this point.
God damn it. I'm sorry.
You put it on every character and use it like once a campaign, maybe.
Oh my god, I'm also, gonna use it.
Has ArmorX used it?
Back on the frying up rats thing, I will say that's very on brand. Is when I asked him about his dream, one of his bullet points was fry up some space squirrels.
Damn.
I'm a fucking Boy Scout. What do you expect?
He ticked that off early. Achieved a dream on the first fucking mission?
Hey, listen.
What day?
Some dreams don't die, okay?
This rocks. I'm so glad we're back.
We are back, boy.
I missed it, man. These past couple of months, we haven't been doing it. There's been a hole in my week.
There's been a hole in my pants, dude.
Well, now you can fill your pants.
With D&D, yeah. Hell yeah.
Alright, I'm heading up. See ya, dudes.
Alright.
Alright, yo.